Hey everyone, welcome back to my series on 90s music nostalgia. This is part 4. Starting off with a Bush song, The Chemicals Between Us. Man, I remember loving this song. I love the sound design. The way the guitars... I want you to remember... Amazing space in this song. They really are easing you in, and it's very exciting. It's very suspenseful. I also just love this very static melody. This is a great example of a melody that doesn't really change note, but it's the rhythm that makes it compelling for the most part. The drum groove I love. I feel like it's like a drum loop of some kind, like a sample. It's got that like Alanis Morissette drum groove feel to it. I don't know exactly how else to label it. I just know the sound, and I know that I always enjoy that, especially in rock music. It just has a nice kind of feeling to it. And the chorus though is coming, and I love it. No, that's a kisser, baby. Okay, so the verse and chorus are in different keys. That's just a really cool feeling. It's like this huge shift. Chemicals between us. Walls that lie between us, lying in this bed. Oh, and the drums there, we got this like... It's like it's built out of delays on like a snare sample. And then this guitar part. The chemicals displaced, there is no love to say. Like they just really knew how to use delay. The producer just really knew how to use delay to create rhythmic interest and to add more dimension to things. It's so beautiful. Okay, well, I still love that song. It holds up. Okay, next, I wouldn't say I was into this song, but I know it's very nostalgic. And this is Even Flow by Pearl Jam. Maybe he'll see a little better Saturdays. God, the reverse reverb. I forgot about that part. I love that. He goes, mwah. Before that, listen. Saturdays. Oh, hey, now. Faces that he sees, I'm a gonna aim them for me. Yeah. Oh, no. It's in between keys. I do like the chorus. Dramatic chord coming up. Do you know what chord that is? Excuse me. It's the flat six. It makes everything better. Okay, I'm just gonna pretend this is in D, even though it's in like D half sharp or something. So good. This is also an example of something that's called mode mixture. When you have like a major key, then you substitute in like a chord from the minor key, which is what that is. You can hear the like major, minor, major, minor. The 90s were so good. The 90s was so good at using mode mixture, and I want it to come back because it's a great way to spice up music. Ooh, my favorite game by the Cardigans. This is a great track. It sounds like a guitar, but sometimes it actually sounds like a voice, and I'm not 100% sure which one it is. Love her voice. It's got this like girl next door kind of sound, but at the same time there's this attitude to it. And she's also got this really beautiful, I wouldn't call it a vibrato, well maybe it's a vibrato, but it's kind of this waviness to her voice. I guess it's a vibrato, but it's very liquidy. It's not like it just sounds like she's kind of wavering. I'm losing my favorite game. I don't know. I just really, every time she sings a single note, I'm like, oh, the production is so pristine. They couldn't have done this better. It's so, so great. Oh. These chords, so that big buzzy bass line was going through the whole verse, and now it's the one thing that kind of continued, not the one thing, but it's the main thing that kind of continued into the chorus, but now it's like these beautiful soft pads, and the bass kind of just stays on one note for the most part, and then it goes to another note, but while it's staying on the one note, the chords are changing over it. So this is called a pedal point. It's kind of like this consistent foundation, and everything is kind of moving against it, and it creates this really cool, intriguing sound. So let's see if we can figure out the chords. So, C minor. Okay, so. Oh, man. And then it goes. The second time that she repeats everything, the bass actually moves with the chords. It's this great, like, sort of a delayed gratification feeling of like. I love the way this phrase happened. Then that chord comes in from the verse. Oh, and then they hit us with this chord, which is it's called a major 5 chord or a dominant 5. This is a very classical way to sort of wrap up a phrase. Makes it really satisfying to go back. And then the There's so many other cool things that happen in the song, like the way that they phrase things, the way they extend phrases after. Losing my favorite game. Oh no. First time she goes, losing my little aim, but the second time she goes aim, and she brightens her voice to aim, so it kind of starts to bite you. It's just all these little details add up to like an incredibly well done production that serves the song fully. Like, it does it justice. Oh my gosh, Butterfly by Crazy Town. This is Okay. This is one of those songs that, you know, the lyrics are quite spicy. And to me, it almost doesn't match the beauty of the song. I feel torn. I'm torn. Nothing's right, I'm torn. Oh, that's another 90s song right there. Oh, man. Natalie Imbruglia. Like, if that was an instrumental, I would be, like, 1,000% into that. D chord. I don't know if it's major or minor. It's ambiguous. Come my lady, come my lady, you're my butterfly, sugar baby. Come my lady, come my lady, you're my butterfly, sugar baby. Such a sexy, pretty little thing. This April bitch, you got me sprung with your tongue ring. And I ain't gonna lie, cause your loving gets me high. So to keep you by my side, there's nothing that I won't try. Oh my god, so 90s.
Eyes and the eyes and the looks to kill. Time is passing, I'm asking, could this be real? Cause I can't sleep, I can't hold still. The only thing I really know is she got sex appeal. I can feel
too much is
delivering you the woman that I want. So I'm putting it down. Come by the day, you're my pretty baby, I'll make your legs shake to me.
Okay, now moving into some Collective Soul and some Fuel and some Toadies. I'm excited. I'm gonna play just a couple from Collective Soul because it was a big deal for me in the 90s. Shine. Oh. And that's true. It's 90s overload. That guitar tone is amazing. I don't play guitar, so I have no idea how that's happening, but it sounds so distorted, but also very warm. I really can feel here. I'm sorry. Maybe I can feel them too. The overtones. It's just so buzzy. And then that drum groove is so accented. So basically this song is like, it has a primary rhythm and the drums are doing it and the guitar is doing it and the vocals are doing it. They're all synced up. Give me a word, give me a song. Show me where to look. The guitarist. Okay, what's the guitarist's name? I have to find out. It's Dean Rowland. Dean. Really nice taste here, I think. That. The way he's going between the chords on those rhythmic accents is just really satisfying. This isn't Mixolydian, which is also known as rock major. C sharp. So they're probably tuned to C sharp. Again, don't play guitar, but I've talked to enough guitarists by now or analyze their music, or you guys have commented that I now understand a little bit about the tunings and stuff, so. That's the rock major part. Regular major doesn't have that chord. This is the edgy rock chord. Oh, it's so pretty. And then it resolves. And then. Yeah. Yeah. Nice vocal harmony there. Show me where to look. Show me where to look. Show me where to look. See how the drums are just playing with the guitar? Yeah. Things kind of got more bluesy there. Darker instead of. Yeah. Vocal harmonies. Light shine down, light shine down. It's kind of, yeah, it's blues. Oh man, Fuel. I loved Fuel. I got a couple of their albums. Here's two hits, I think, from Sunburn. Shimmer and Bittersweet. Oh my gosh. Oh, I'm so excited. I haven't listened to these in a while.
She calls me from the cold. Just when I was low, feeling short of stable. All that she intends, and all she keeps inside is in on the label. We'll forget the past.
But you know, the chords are so descriptive that you don't even need a bass line. And the guitar is also so rhythmic that you don't even need drums.
And I break at the bend. We're here and
cello.
Now. Will we ever be again? Cause I have found all that shimmers in this world is sure to fade away again.
Man, these are some beautiful chords. Let's just...
Calls me from the cold.
Oh, yeah. It has a Lydian sound to it. Oh, that makes sense. This part always reminded me of Lavender, and maybe he even says the word lavender or something. I thought that was so descriptive of the way the chords felt. There's something floral about them. I think it's because it's rooted in this very Lydian sound, which is a very open, curious, light, bright scale. It's like major, but ultra major. That's so freaking beautiful. But that back and forth feeling, it feels so tense and incomplete. It's like kind of lost sounding. And I think that really makes what's about to come so much more meaningful. She says she's ashamed. Can she take me for, sorry, a while? I'm somewhere in between. They weren't thinking about it that way, like, let's use this scale. It's just something that happened because of the chords that they chose in the key of E minor. This chord and this chord are both in E minor, but the way they're kind of going between them,
I'm somewhere between,
without playing E minor for a while, is what makes it feel sort of in lost and in between, and that Lydian scale I was talking about. But anyway, that's so beautiful. I've always wondered why it felt like that.
And I break at the bend. We're here and now. Will we ever be again? Cause she says that love is for fools that fall behind. And I'm somewhere between.
Lydian again, Lydian sound. got this line. Oh, the cellist. Kill me. That bass. They didn't have to do that. It's so great. And then he varies his melody, and it's so amazing. So you got the up higher. Such a great way to vary a melody. It's kind of, he just went, and then it's the same two notes. He changed the order, basically. I think the first Fuel song I heard was Bittersweet, though. Like tone. In love. It's a flat six chord, of course it is.
Seven wants to miss, and everything that's good is gone. Solid for the glory from the piers. Silver comb priest to scratch your back and twist the knife to bone. Ow.
I'm in love with the rhythm guitarist. This is so good. I just love the chromatic walk up. Listen to his chug. It's so rhythmic. I mean, obviously it's rhythm guitar, but you know what I mean. It's more than just like the harmonic rhythm, which is like the chord changes. It's like, this is practically percussion. Oh yeah, and then is this some kind of gate they have on the guitar, which is cutting the signal in very even increments? So it's going, it's like stuttering. It sounds like it's going stuttering. I love that effect. It adds a rhythmic intensity to the whole thing that it would be very different without that.
Drink to the veil, and all these things I carry now. In this bittersweet, in this bittersweet now.
Next is Possum Kingdom by Toadies. Oh, I'm expecting to get the nostalgia hard for this. Oh, it's super right hand. I don't think I knew that. That's like harp.
Make up your mind.
It's not in the left at all.
Decide to walk with me around the lake tonight.
What?
Around the lake tonight by my side.
Guitar is so memorable. Wow, 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 wow. This sounds so bluesy to me. It's like that Mixolydian sound, but also just blues. Also E, okay. That one and four chord, that's a blues thing. On last side, it's that tense. Bluesy seven. Actually, I think that first chord is a dominant seventh chord.
round.
So the first time he goes, make up your mind, da 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 da, around the lake tonight. That's where he's staying. And then the second time, I'm not gonna lie, I'll not be a gentleman, da da. So he goes to a different part of the scale and kind of riffs in a similar way up there.
Dark secret.
Listen to that bass line.
Dum, 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 dum.
And then he goes all the way up.
My lover, be my lover, yeah. Don't be afraid. I don't mean to scare you. So help me, Jesus.
What a fun progression. I forgot to talk about the shortened phrase, right? So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So the first time they just cut that last... that last chord short. I love that. Okay, this bridge is so great.
Do you wanna be my angel? Give it up to me.
This is very dramatic sounding to me. All these major chords.
Give it up to me. Give it up to me.
And then this one is so dark. All major chords, but related in very twisted ways. When I was young, listening to the song in the 90s, I liked to make fun of him lovingly when he said wanna. I would go, do you wanna be? Do you wanna die? Wanna.
My angel, so help me.
That's a very creative way to get back to. Are you still there? It's 12:40 in the morning. And I'm not gonna tell you how long I've been doing, 2 hours.